Hi, here's version 2 of Freight Train. I will first show you how it's going to sound and give the explanation after it. Here it is. The intro of version 2 starts with 3 bass notes on count 2, 3 and 4. So measure 1 goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. In version 1 of Freight Train, you could hear that all melody notes were played on the same count as the bass notes. So you were using your thumb and middle finger at the same time, like this. In version 2, there will be melody notes played off the beat. So your fingers really have to be independent from your thumb. I will show measure 2 and 3 played on the beat and 1 off the beat. So you could hear the difference. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So all the bass notes are played exactly the same as version 1. The only difference is the melody. You can practice the first 3 measures to getting used to playing the melody off the beat. Once again, your fingers really need to work independent from your thumb. You can practice this by starting with the thumb only, like this. Then play the melody off the beat, like this. So this is a normal C chord and I hit the high E with my middle finger. So if you have a steady bass going, it will work out well. Here are the first 3 measures. Here are measure 4 till 7 slowed down. You can use the same approach as measure 2 and 3. Measure 8 starts with a hammer-on on the B string, like this. So you hit the B string once, and then firmly press your first finger to the first position of the B string. And then you have to add the bass to it. In measure 9 there are 2 different bass notes that lead you to the E7 chord. So there's a G bass, and on the 4th count you play the F with the thumb, like this. So measure 9 goes like this. And there's the E7. In measure 10 and 11 there are more strings played at the same time. The chord is an E7, which is played like this. So it's a normal E, but the pink plays the 3rd of the B string. So it starts with an E bass note. And after that you have to hit 4 strings at the same time. So I play the D string with my thumb, the G string with my index finger, the middle finger plays the B string, and the ring finger plays the high E. On count four, you have to place your first finger over string G, B, and E. Here's measure 10 and 11, slow down. When some melody notes need to be played fast behind each other, it's easier to use your index finger and middle finger after each other. For example, when you have a couple of melody notes like this. Now I only use my middle finger, I can't make too much speed. But if you use your index finger after the middle finger, it's a lot easier to make some speed. Like this. So in measure 12, it's easier to also use your index finger on the B string. Here are measure 12 and 13 slowed down. For measure 14 till 17, you can use the same approach as the first measures. If you like to play the song again, you can mix measure 17 and measure 1 together, like this. So count 1 is measure 17, the C chord, and on count 2, 3 and 4, you have measure 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and you're at the beginning again. Here's the entire song slowed down and one time played faster. It's really important that your fingers work independent from your thumb. And once again, it's wise to practice this slowly. Tap your foot and take the song step by step. After this, there's one last suggestion on how to play this with a little damping. One last suggestion is to play this with the bass part damped, so it will sound like this. So you have to put the palm of your right hand over the bridge, like here.